is Sister Chandler with your offering appeal, which will be found in Hebrews 13, 15, and 16. Through Jesus, therefore, let us continually offer to God a sacrifice of praise, the fruit of lips that confess his name. And do not forget to do good and to share with others, for with such sacrifices God is pleased. And always remember that we've been blessed to be a blessing to others. Amen?
Amen.
And just as a reminder, we have several avenues for you to bring your offerings to the church. You can put them through the mail slot, or you can mail them to us at Siloam Baptist Church, 1329 Willow Street in Norristown, PA. Our zip code is 19401. And we also have online available where you can make your deposit. If you have any question, please call the church office or see the information listed at the bottom. God bless.
Greetings, one and all. Welcome you to once again to our services, and we hope and pray that the services of the past have been a blessing, and that this service today will be a blessing and encouragement to your soul and spirit. Our text today comes from the Gospel of Luke, the Gospel of Luke, chapter 4, beginning with verse 39. Gospel of Luke, chapter 4, beginning with verse 39. So he bent over her and rebuked the fever, and it left her. She got up at once and began to walk, wait on them. When the sun was setting, the people brought to Jesus all who had various kinds of sicknesses and laid his hands on each one. He healed them. Moreover, demons came out of many people shouting, "You are the Son of God." But he rebuked them and would not allow them to speak because they knew he was the Christ. Healing is possible. Silently now we wait for thee, ready, my God, thy will to see. Open our ears, our hearts, our minds, our souls, and our spirits, and illume in them, Spirit divine. In Jesus' name, amen. It appears that the whole country, if not the whole world, is affected by this coronavirus. Listening to the news yesterday, it said that more than 60,000 people have died in America from this disease. And here's the real tragedy, it's not over yet. One would be foolish not to be troubled or concerned about this deadly disease and its effects on one, our loved ones, and ourselves. And while I am sure the doctors are doing all they know to do, many of these have the best minds, the best training, the best equipment, and that eventually there will be some kind of a cure. But what about those who have it now? What about those who show signs of symptoms, or even worse, signs of the disease itself? And also, what about those of us who are disease-free, but we know of people, perhaps family and friends, who must deal with this deadly disease right now, every single day? What can we say and do to give comfort and divine healing to the ones who are caught up in this nightmare? Today, I want you to know that there is help and there is healing through our Lord Jesus Christ. For there is no sickness, no disease, no pandemic that Jesus cannot handle. There is no scientific discovery that will be greater than the God we serve. Siloam family, this is a divine moment in time to put our faith to work. We say we believe God can do anything. We say that God is our healer. Well, now is the hour when we must lift up our faith and trust in God. And if I'm right, somebody ought to say amen. Today, I want to build up your faith concerning what God can and will do. I personally cannot guarantee anything, but I can guarantee that the God we serve has a lot of experience in the healing business. And if he healed in the past, he can heal right now. It is times like these that test our faith. But child of God, do not be discouraged or dismayed. Our God is who he taught us. And he is able to heal somebody right now if we walk by faith and not by sight. This morning, I want to share several examples that demonstrate what our God can do. You see, healing is not a new thing to God. He's been in the healing business for thousands of years. And if he could do it then, he can do it now. For Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. But the question is, do you believe it? Today, I want to share with you some scriptures which demonstrate how our God is king over diseases rather than the diseases king over him. Friends, the disease we face may cause us to be discouraged, but this pandemic is nothing in comparison to our God. If you believe that, say amen. In Matthew chapter 9, verse 18 to 22, Jesus encounters a woman who has been bleeding blood for 12 long years. Think about it. Every day bleeding for 12 years. Everybody knows that if you bleed like this, you will surely die. But the woman heard about Jesus, and she made up in her mind that if she could just touch the hem of his garment, she would be made whole and well. My friends, there is nothing wrong with seeking the help of the Lord. There's a story in the Bible of a woman who nagged Jesus until she got his attention. There's somebody under the sound of my voice going through something by yourself, and you better stop that and begin to nag Jesus for an answer until you get it. So be faithful, be prayerful, be consistent without quitting, and see what the Lord will do. Child of God, healing is on the way. Help is on the way. Salvation is on the way if you keep on believing. Then there's Mark chapter 2, verses 9 through 12, which tell the story of a crippled man who cannot walk. And to make matters worse, his friends thought that he was not worthy of Jesus' attention, but not Jesus himself. Instead of putting the man down, in Mark chapter 2, Jesus says to him, "Your sins are forgiven. Get up, take up your mat, and go home." And the Bible says the man gets up, takes up his mat, and walks out in full view of everybody. And when the people saw what had happened to this once lame man, they began to rejoice and praise the Lord, saying, "We ain't never seen anything like this." There's somebody or something going on in your life that is pulling you down I want you to know that there is hope and healing in the name of Jesus. There is a fresh start in the name of Jesus. There's room for the impossible and the improbable in the name of Jesus. Child of God, don't give up. Give it to Jesus and see what he will do. You see, cancer can't compete without Jesus. Diabetes cannot outdo our Jesus. Heart failure cannot hide from our Jesus. Depression cannot outdo our Jesus. Anybody see where I'm going? We can overcome anything if we follow Jesus. We can do all things, my Bible says, through Christ who strengthens us. Thirdly, Luke 17 tells the story of Jesus' encounter with 10 men who had the leprosy disease, which was deadly back then. If there was anything like that leprosy disease today, it would be this disease of this virus that we're going through. It was a sure killer then, just as this virus is a sure killer now. But one day, one of the lepers saw Jesus and cried out to him, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." Maybe this man heard what Jesus had done for others. When he saw Jesus for himself, he could not stop himself from crying out, "Have mercy on us." I wonder, is there anybody here who has gotten to the point when only Jesus can help you out? Only Jesus can turn a wrong to right. Only Jesus can bring a dead dream back to life. Only Jesus can wash away your guilt and shame and disgrace. And you called on his name and he truly set you free of whatever burden you had in your life. And yes, church, Jesus set you free. Am I right? Will he do it? Can he do it? Oh, you ought to give him some praise. Finally, I would be remiss if I did not tell you this story from the Gospel of John. The story of a man who was blind from birth. He didn't know much about, we don't know much about him. We do not even know his name or where he was from. We do not even know if he was a believer. But this we do know. This man got Jesus' attention and sympathy. And so Jesus spat in some dirt and put some mud pies in the man's eyes and told him to go and wash it out in the pool of Siloam. But here's the important part of the story. For John 9 tells us the man went and he washed and he came back seeing. When Jesus returned, this man was so changed that his whole family and friends did not recognize him. Friends, don't tell me prayer does not work. Don't tell me that some things are impossible with God. Don't tell me what God does not care, that God does not care or make provisions for people whom others treat like nobodies. No matter who you are or what your situation is, healing is possible. Wholeness is possible. Salvation is possible. Siloam, in the midst of this most recent epidemic, let us put our faith to work. Let us pray like our lives depend on it. You know why? Because it does. Let us trust God for our healing from this virus. Let us rally around one another and come together and let's see what the Lord will do. I believe help is on the way. Healing is on the way. Salvation is on the way. Forgiveness is on the way. Love is on the way. Joy and peace is on the way. So come on. Come on, somebody, for help is on the way. Anybody need some help today? Anybody tired of trying to get your life together, but it just doesn't seem to work? Anybody know that God is there and God does love you, but God is not in your life? I want you to know today, God is as close as a prayer. And if you will only pray this prayer, you too can be like this man and receive the healing that comes from Jesus and Jesus alone. If that's you, sir, if that's you, man, bow your heads with me right now where you are and pray this prayer with me. Lord Jesus, say it out loud. Lord Jesus, I need you. I need you. Come into my heart. Come into my heart and be my Savior and Lord. Be my Savior and my Lord. I confess that I have sinned. I confess that I have sinned. But I ask you, Lord, to forgive me, to cleanse me, and to give me a fresh start. Thank you, Lord. Say it out loud. Thank you, Lord, for forgiving my sins. Thank you, Lord. Say it again. Thank you, Lord, for giving me a new chance. And for the rest of my life, I will live for you. In Jesus' name, amen. If you prayed that prayer, you are a born-again Christian. I want you to contact Siloam Baptist Church and let us know how we can help you. In Jesus' name, amen.